This is ThinkTech Hawaii. Community matters here.
Welcome to Understanding China, brought to you live from the ThinkTech studios in downtown Honolulu through the support of Asia Pacific Group. I'm Michael North, and our host today is my wife from our Beijing office, Xiaofang Zhou North. Now, normally Xiaofang is in Beijing and I'm here and we're doing interviews across the internet, but today we're together in the same studio. Now through this series, we speak with key leaders in China, government, business, academia, the arts, about China today, its future, its hopes and dreams, its plans in the world, and above all, its people. We help our international audience to see China through Chinese eyes by talking directly to the people who are making it happen and leading the largest nation in the world today. Xiaofang, we have some special guests to introduce.
Aloha. I'm so glad to be here, and we have hosted seven episodes in Beijing, and now we're live in Honolulu. Welcome to my guest, Mr. Lin Fan Lin. He's working at the CIPG, which is one of the largest publishing company called China International Publishing Group, and Beijing Mozi, and he's a director at the Beijing Mozi Company. And this is his beautiful wife, Xu Xing. Welcome to Hawaii.
Hawaii.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Yeah. I'm going to speak, talk to them in Chinese and translate in English. 首先先欢迎你们两个人哈。 这次你们是第一次来夏威夷，
对吗？
对夏威夷的第一印象是什么？ 帆林。
非常的阳光， 非常的放松， 非常的这个明亮的一个城市。
许昕。
这儿的人非常的友好，都有一张开心的笑脸，都是很真诚，很真实。
So this is actually first time for Fan Lin and Xu Xing. The first impression in Hawaii, Fan Lin's response is, it's very lively and sunshine, beautiful ocean and mountain. And Xu Xing, very inspired by the people of Hawaii because the spirit of aloha. Now, 我知道你们是夫妻哈，可不可以介绍一下您的家庭有几个孩子啊？
我们的家庭现在有两个女儿，一个12岁，一个6岁。
都是两个女孩？对，两个女孩。 Okay, so Fan Lin and Xu Xing, they are a couple, and they have two lovely daughters. One is 6 years old, and one is 12. 那他们现在都在学校吗？一个小学，一个上初中吗？都一个在上五年级，一个今年9月份就上学1年级。Okay, so the first one, the youngest one will be into the first grade, and the second one is in the fifth grade. 那他们在学校学习压力有没有啊？你们有没有感觉到？
老大。
老大，有一些压力，因为面临马上要升初中，六年制，然后马上要小升初。So they have a little pressure on the new, for the eldest one is going to the junior high, and for the youngest one is going to be from kindergarten to first grade.
那我想了解一下，你们怎么是有两个孩子呀？中国不是一胎吗？一胎制吗？现在就是中国政府就是现在对这个计划生育这个政策也放开了。然后呢，因为我们两个本身就是独生子女这一代，然后现在就是允许我们独生，如果两方只要有一方是独生子女就可以生两个。So
I asked them, how come you have two children? Because in China is a one child, one policy. Actually the young couple can have two kids. But for Fan Lin, because they are one child, only child in the family, so they can have the, if one party is their only child, 但 they can have two children. Congratulations, 祝贺你们有两个孩子。
谢谢谢谢。
那我想了解一下当今的这个家庭哈，你们都肯定都是双职工嘛。那这个孩子的教育主要是在学校和家庭，你们是怎么样又有工作然后送孩子上学，怎么样的那个教育这个孩子每天的这个成长啊，跟家庭度一起的时光啊。
因为中国一般都是男主外女主内，我更多的是在照顾家庭，然后还有一些还有我们的父母都在帮助我们然后是学习在教育方面呢，我们可能我会更多的去关注他们
比如说呢你怎么去关心他们的这个教育方面学习方面
我们可能会因为我们个人的能力是有限的我们可能会到我们有另外的一些机构
课外的
这个课程对课外的一些教育对对对
So you know because Fan Lin and Xu Xing they both work and they have two children I say how you you know judging your juggling your work and family and education for the kids and she said you know normally in China the men will work outside and the womenMinli will take care of the family. And Xu Xing, of course, will be the one spending more time with the kids for their studies and, of course, their living. And then they have grandparents. They take a lot of time to spend with the kids, especially with, in the weekends. 那我想就是他们跟祖母啊，就是外祖父啊，爷爷老奶奶啊，可能都是在周末时间比较多一些是吧
对老人像我们父母也会下午因为我们孩子放学很早一般是3点多就放学老人会去接因为我们都在上班
非常好So in China you know evenbefore they have a two generation or third generation living togetherbut now even they have they living a separate apartment or separateplaces but they still taking care of each other so the grandparents will pick up pick the children it's very often you can see in the school Fan Lin 我想知道了解这些刚才我们谈了很多家庭的事情哈现在我想谈谈你们的事业您的这个工作主要是您主导工作是什么
我们现在这个工作主要是负责中国的这些文化中国的图书然后我们经过我们来翻译然后翻译成14个语种然后出版到国外让国外的这些人民更多的去了解中国的文化和中国的一些这个国家的一些情况
So since Fan Lin is working, he has a very big responsibility in the publishing and translation company in China. And his responsibility is his company has over the 14 languages and do publishing, printing, and distribution. So 那您的那个公司比如说您可以介绍一本书在国外推出的是哪些
我们现在就是最大的一个出版项目就是我们习近平主席的这个谈治国理政这本书现在已经翻译成大概30个语种然后今年可能还要扩大到45个语种
So I asked Fan Lin what they're working, the current working on the translation. It's about President Xi Jinping, how to the leadership about, of the country. So they have translated into 30 languages and they're going to translate it, extend it to 45. So that's one of the main work.for Fan Lin 那您的工作看来是挺紧张的哈也很任务也很艰巨那您对家庭的这些付出因为我知道刚才是外主
男
主外嘛那您对家庭比如说孩子您跟他们有没有更多的时间在一起呢
我实际上非常希望能够跟孩子的时间更多一些，但是呢，因为确实一方面工作的压力也是比较大，然后呢，第二个呢，就是说，家庭的这边的这个生活的一些负担，我们也要去扛起来，有这样的责任，
嗯，
所以说，有很多时候就难免会这个疏离，哎，顾不上，对，
嗯，
所以我尽量是在周末，嗯，只要是周末，休息的时间，我就尽量的是跟孩子在一起，
So since Fan Lin has a full time and he's a director and actually CEO of the company, and most of his work is outside, and I know Fan Lin as a personal friend as well in China, and I know how busy he is. He travels intensively all over China. And I say, how you balance the family? And he trying to spend as much as the time with the children, especially on weekends and holidays. And 您最近带孩子就是有没有出去玩啊？最后一次是哪一次？
我有点记不清，像
so maybe 很久以
前了，也不算很久吧，就是但是尽量每个周末尽量就带他们去他们孩子喜欢去的游乐场啊，看看电影啊。然后吃点好的东西，啊，
吃点好吃的，大家在一起到公园呀，
最爱带孩子去抓娃娃，
抓娃娃，是不是抓娃娃？
那个抓娃娃机，
抓娃娃机
啊 ，OK， 就像那个 David Buster。So I say when is your last time you took your kids to play? You know, and he can't remember the date, but he tried his best to spend more time. The last time, the kids really love the game.Like a Dave and Buster and movie, and of course visit your their grandparents, 去看爷爷奶奶或者是哈，yeah， 那我想知道您的工作，因为您也是全日工吧，
对，
您的工作是您为什么选择这个工作呢？
我现在就职于北京石刻艺术博物馆，它也是就是一个非盈利性的公益性的一个机构，更多的把中国的历史、北京的历史，传播给下一代，然后传播给世界。
Okay, so Xu Xing is also a full-time staff at the Beijing carving.
Stone carving
art museum. And they collect most carvings on the stone in Beijing. And the majority of them, 他们很多这些石刻是皇家留下来的。So most of the carving is from the emperor family or
书法家
the calligraphy. So they have a full collection of the stone carving. 那你怎么选择的这份工作呢？
一次机会。
一次机会哈。
对。
您能跟我们分享一下怎么在中国怎么样会找到这样工作？
现在这都是公开招聘
啊 ，OK，
公开招聘，因为这个属于公益性的，完全是国家资助。所以我们这职位各个职位都要进行公开招聘，面向社会人士还有大学生。
So I say, how did you find this work? It seems very important with all these collections, and you know they open for to the public. It's a non-profit organization, all funded by the government, and so they have a regular. Just like America, you have to apply with your background, your own interest, and your qualification. They have to go through that to get a job. 非常好哈。那我想就是你们来到美国嘛，几天了？有三四天了，都去了哪里了？
恐龙湾，
恐龙湾 ，OK，
很美的地方。
OK，
然后在那儿让我完成了一个心愿，福气。
OK， so I say, where did you go for the last few days? Xu Xing loves swim, and he went to Hamada Bay. It's very beautiful. There's lots of fish, and she got a goggle and snorkeling. Well, 你有什么新的 有什么新的打算？下一次去哪里？
我们后天吧，再要去大岛，
哦，
然后主要是去看那个世界上比较著名的这个活 火山，
哦，
还有那个星空，
啊，
美丽的星空。
So they are going to Big Island to see the volcano and the stars.I know in China right now, you know, I grew up there, but we don't see star now. So I wish you have a very good time in Big Island.
Thank you.
So this is a couple in China, husband and wife. And I'm very interested to know how they met. 我想了解一下就是你们是怎么相识的。
哦，我们还是比较传统，我们是经过这个父辈的这个就是老我们的父母的这个朋友相互介绍，然后认识的。
Okay, hold it out. We're going to have an advertisement and we'll be back.
This is ThinkTech Hawaii, raising public awareness.
Aloha, I'm Richard Concepcion, the host of Hispanic Hawaii. You can watch my show every other Tuesday at 2 p.m. We will bring you entertainment, educational, and also we tell you what is happening right here within our community. ThinkTech Hawaii. Aloha.
They said I could play, so any chance to play at all, you know, that's my life.
Aloha, welcome to Hawaii. This is Prince Dykes, your host of The Prince of Investing, coming to you guys each and every Tuesday at 11 a.m. right here on ThinkTech Hawaii. Don't forget to come by and check out some of the great information on stocks, investing, your money, all the other great stuff, and I'll be your host. See you Tuesday.
Welcome to Sister Power. I'm your host, Sharon Thomas Yarbrough, where we motivate, educate, empower, and inspire all women. We are live here every other Thursday at 4 p.m., and we welcome you to join us here at Sister Power. Aloha and thank you.
Welcome back, and you are at...Understanding China with our guest from China, Bin Fan Lin, and his wife, Xu Xing. We're talking about the China, the family and their work and how they, you know, this is their first time to Hawaii. So, 下一个我们在我想知道哈，作为一个家庭来讲，肯定在社会上和教育上，家庭责任肯定也会还有工作，你们肯定会有一些挑战性的。我想了解呢，就是你们最就是最对你们来说最挑战的是什么？
对我们来说，可能对男人来说就是工作跟家庭怎么来平衡。而且像我们这一代的就是独生子女，因为都是家里都是只有一个，就是老人这个时候在变老，然后孩子在长大，然后都需要我们去照顾，需要我们去关注。但是有时候呢，又加上事业工作的这个压力，所以很难去平衡。所以这个对我们来说，现在可能是最大的一个压力。
So, you know, how to balance with work and family and education, the children, the most challenge Fan Lin feel is the, you know, the parents are getting old and need a lot of attention and care, and the children are growing. So in between, and then there's a demand on work, how to balance that. This is one of the most challenge for family,I think that there, especially for Fan Lin, who is the only child, there's no uncle or auntie in the family. And all they have is their, you know, older parents and the kids and the wife. 这个是很难。那你觉得对就是最大的挑战是什么呢？
孩子的教育问题。
孩子教育问题。
对。
So for Xu Xing is the education.How to, you know, have the children to focus, 就是让孩子能够集中的哈，让他们能够有一个很好的学习的环境， 这个是很重要，
对
吧？
因为我们是两个孩子，对于中国这个两个孩子，现在可能慢慢的会越来越多，因为中国这个计划生育政策刚刚放开，
对，
但是我们这个应该就是像他们这个年龄呢，应该很少，大部分人还都是独生子女。就是因为我们本身就是独生子女，我们
对
于这个两个孩子的教育问题，两个孩子就是怎么能达到平衡，我也不知道该怎么好怎么说哈、啊。然后那个他们两个经常会有冲突，怎么会去安慰一方，怎么能教育好，就反正是这一块我觉得压力也挺大的。
So for Xixing, this is a very, very personal, I think, because when you have a two girls and there is a conflict sometimes on how to resolve, find the best resolution for the kids. And as you know, most of Chinese family, they have only one child because the one child policy was started in 70s up to the 20, it's just now open. So a lot of family facing the similar, I think a similar issue. 对，现在我觉得可能这个跟美国的家庭呢、美国家庭也有同样的这个问题怎么样来平衡，一个是时间上教育上哈，对孩子的成长啊培养他们的独立性啊这些。我想呢因为你们可以再谈一些你们对孩子教育的方式方法，比如说你们是怎么教育怎么教育他们，比如说在家里面他们要做错事了，你们会让他们，比如说在美国他们可能会坐在一个小板凳要自己去思考，或关一个屋子里面自己去思考。那你们在就是在中国嘛如果孩子犯了错误，你们是怎么去教育他们？
这个其实我觉得可能这个所有的国家的教育方式其实都差不多，但是我个人的想法就是说，其实不是说在乎这个如何去用什么样的方法来教育他，而是希望他能够懂得就是家长对他的这个教育的这个道理，如果说这个方式能够让他明白这个道理，那我们可能就会去选择这样的方式。
你能举一个例子吗？比如说你的孩子想买一个东西，你觉得
我一般他要买什么东西的话，我会去问他你要告诉我你买这个东西的理由是什么，如果我觉得你的这个理由充分，我会买给你如果说你的这个他的这个理由我就说，如果你要是都说服不了我，那可能我们会考虑一下，或者我会给你一个其他的建议
So you know when you are parent, I'm sure you have this sometimes the kids, they made a mistake or they asking too much, and how you educate them, how you teach them to behave, right? So Fan Lin give an example. For instance, the girl wants something toy or something beyond study, because they're focused on really they hope they're do more work, study hard, right? Then Fan Lin will want them to explain why you need this, what is the reason, right? So they have to think why. They have to thinking that they have to give a second thought to ask themselves why they need this, right? So if that reason is a good reason, then they will buy for the kid. If it's not a good reason, then they will say, okay, let's wait. 这样的话就不是那么容易不是娇惯哈，就是说孩子想要什么就要就给什么。So 那比如说哈那个孩子的自由的时间，那他们自由时间你们会比如说随便，就是他们是不是可以随时看电视啊，还是有时间限制啊在家里面你们怎么样去
起码要完成作业，完成作业以后有自己自由的时间，睡觉前 要看半个小时的书。
哦，有这样的。So for so they can watch TV, and they have this freedom, but the condition is they have to finish their homework. So when you're done your homework and you have some free time and watch TV, 我想这个电视也是跟大家一起，是吧？这个是更好一个特别好的一个共度的时间。
现在，而且现在就是还有 iPad
啊，
他们可以去选择看自己愿意看的东西
啊。那你们对，比如说有些电影是不允许看电视这样的，
基本上
iPad 它也有这个
对有那个功能可以限制它。
有功能的 ，OK。So they of course for the movie they have their own iPad.They can choose what they like, but also there's a restriction for the age, and you know some are not appropriate. 那我想，it's a similar to I have a daughter myself, and I think I gave her too much freedom because I want her to be independent. I want her to be.I'm busy, so I think that's a little, sometimes my daughter maybe take the freedom as too much, take advantage or, but anyway, mm-hmm. I think the children probably it's better to structure with the timing, discipline, and explaining, those are is very important for teaching the children. Yeah. So, 你们有什么问题吗？对美国的家庭教育，或者是对夏威夷呀、啊，对初次美国有什么？
对，我就想问问美国的孩子是不是像中国孩子一样，周末也要去上。这种课外培训班、
啊、
然后他们在家里的学习是不是也要需要家长来监督或者说是来辅导、
啊、So, well, we ask a lot of questions about how they raise kids and how, their balanced life. And Fan Lin has a question to American, how we raising the, children, do they have to finish their homework and do we have, is there a special outside curriculum they need to attend? Actually, there are. Most of the kids, I think the timing, they finish 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. Once they finish a little bit early, I should speak Chinese. 那中国的就是美国的孩子呢，他们学校呢上课呢，差不多也是一点周三呢是一点下课，然后平时呢差不多2点多钟。那根据孩子的兴趣和爱好呢，他们也可以去学舞蹈，去学音乐，游泳，什么班课程班也就是课外班也挺多的。So I explained there's a more outside curriculum like a swimming class and piano class, music and dance, hula. And I think American parents are also very focused on the children's education. It's similar to, to our Chinese parents. And there's lots of assistant classes outside the regular classes. Yeah, 就是说每节美国也跟我们都差不多。
但是美国的孩子可能是更多的是体验式的那种课程，就比如说运动、音乐、
yeah.
美术。
Yeah.
但是中国孩子不同的是数学、英语。
So, Fan Lin said that the differences is the, here is more dancing, more activity, and China is mathematics and literature. It's more serious. This is our time is up, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is the Understanding China. We look forward to seeing you next time. Aloha.
Aloha.